product.
Hi Fred, thanks again for spending some time with us again, especially busy IAAPA here. I know you are predominantly sold out, so this isn't all about selling for you, but I know you're busy meeting with all the people, that you, all your buyers and stuff, so we appreciate the time. Did I see correctly now, you have a name for this piece of truck here?
This is what we're calling the T-Rex. It's a new development, and it's a one rail. We'll have a car that fits on this one rail, and it'll have a totally different look to it. Won't be all the cross members, all the pieces, everything that you see in traditional bike, right? And this is for the big, large steel coasters that we're developing.
Right,
so
and
we're not only doing wood coasters, we're going to move into the steel coaster market.
Right, and when we say steel coaster, you have been making steel coasters, but they're not traditional steel coasters in the fact that they are wooden coasters that are now using steel track and are therefore classified as steel. This is going to be all steel, support and steel track.
This will be the more traditional steel support steel coaster structure, where we use the I-box, the steel I-box track on the wood structure.
Right. And of course, making a big steel coaster thing means that you can see possibly new heights, new things like that, stuff. You can go beyond what we've been making so far. Does there seem to be a limit right now, or?
Because the limit is there's a price point on everything.
Right, but I'm talking about as far as the structure, the engineering that you guys discussed. Are you considering possibly going over, obviously over 200 feet, I assume, possibly over 300?
We'll entertain you in any type of structure.
Right.
At any height.
So we might be seeing some real monster coasters from Rocky Mountain.
Some real monster ones.
Okay, can we just step over to the photo over there that you have of this track, so we'll continue it from there so people can get a quick idea of what we're talking about here? Yes. So here's the car. Okay, well, yes.
Okay. Here's a photo, a rendering of what this will look like. So you can see now the rendering has these dogs in it right here.
Right. Right, and then of course here's another photo down here for the people to see.
Yeah.
Now the jagged edges there on these photos, of course, is just the software.
Yeah.
It's not the tracks.
Yeah.
Of course, are going to look like that.
No.
And then of course we've shown people these trains on our website and on our social media. But there it is there again, in case people are wondering what the train looks like. So, and then again, the trains are going to be manufactured by you, like everything else.
Yeah.
The support structure, everything is going to be Rocky Mountain Construction.
Yeah, it'll be manufactured back at our plant in Idaho. Yeah.
Okay, and then now, of course, basically Rocky Mountain doesn't set any limits to what they can do. So I assume since you guys are now coming out with Lightning Rod, a launched wooden roller coaster, it wouldn't be beyond our expectations to one day see one of these being launched then too, possibly.
Absolutely. This could be launched and it could be a gravity hill. It could do anything with this that you could do with the steel coaster that's being done now. Hopefully, we've got a few ideas. So I can't share them right now. A few new ideas.
Right. I assume now, since the track is here, the photos are here, we have some interested parties?
Oh, yes. We have interested parties. Yes.
Okay. Great. And okay, so we've got interested parties. Of course, you can't say who or what. Hopefully, some of them are some major chains, so that way we can see some big budgets being spent, and hopefully we'll be able to see these in multiple locations so people don't have to travel halfway around the world to be able to ride one.
We're thinking that's a possibility, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Fred, thank you once again for your time. We know you're busy, and thank you for spending some of it with us.
You're welcome.